My name is Antanas Sileika, and I'd like to tell you about a powerful new novel published by Guernica Press. It's called The Occidental Hotel. It was written by the late John Bentley Mays and completed just days before he died 4 years ago. In The Occidental Hotel, a brooding fugitive hides out in a crumbling mid-century hotel. He is a racist with a criminal past, and he reflects on the ruins of the American South and at the same time on the life of a German performance artist called Jupp. The fictional Jupp is a thinly veiled cipher for the real-life German artist, the late Joseph Beuys, and the photos in the novel are photos of the art performances by this controversial artist. Here's one of the images. There is no other novel quite like The Occidental Hotel. It echoes the moody worlds of the author W.G. Sebald and incorporates outrageous elements of pulp fiction. This novel of dark romanticism is not for optimists seeking redemption, but for those willing to take a look into a searing heart of darkness. So, who was John Bentley Mays? The Louisiana-born man was the Globe and Mail's art critic in the 80s and 90s. Dogged by a tragic childhood and plagued with lifelong depression, he wrestled with these afflictions while writing and publishing widely his whole life and completing this audacious novel. Why am I telling you this story? Because I was there as John gave birth to the Occidental Hotel. Let me tell you a little bit about that. John Bentley Mays wore shapeless sweatpants and a baggy sweater when he walked into Toronto's Little Italy's Bar Diplomatico to meet me in 2014. He was unshaven, and since he wasn't wearing a hat, the prominent scar on his forehead, where skin cancers had been cut out repeatedly, made him look like a war vet of some kind. He was there yet again to talk about the progress of his novel, The Occidental Hotel. I was shocked and appalled by The Occidental Hotel. John wrote an unconventional piece of work with one of the most horrible anti-heroes I had read since John Fowles's The Collector. And there's no escape from this monster, who suffers no comeuppance, but who, like a poisonous spider, sits in a web with different threads. On September 2nd, 2016, John sent me the final draft of his novel. We made arrangements to meet again at the cafe on September 21st to discuss my notes. On September 16th, he died of a massive heart attack after walking up a hill in Hyde Park with his longtime friend, the literary critic Phil Marchand. This novel is an unblinking look into a heart of darkness of a kind we almost never see in this country. It is also the final document of a razor-sharp mind that helped form Canadian culture over several decades. John Bentley Mays was the subject of a series of portraits by the Canadian artist Gertrude Kearns. One of those portraits is on the cover of The Occidental Hotel. Here's another version, owned by John's widow, the writer Margaret Cannon. My name is Antanas Sileika. I am a novelist and a friend of the late John Bentley Mays, and I wanted to let you know a little bit about his posthumous novel, The Occidental Hotel.